Tara Simmons.
I, Tara Simmons.
Do solemnly declare.
Do solemnly declare.
And will abide by the, excuse me, I am fully subject to the laws of the state of Washington.
I am fully subject to the laws of the state of Washington.
And the laws of the United States.
And the laws of the United States.
And will abide by the same.
And will abide by the same.
I will support the Constitution of the state of Washington.
I will support the Constitution of the state of Washington.
And the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the United States.
I will abide by the rules of professional conduct.
I will abide by the rules of professional conduct.
Approved by the Supreme Court of the state of Washington.
Approved by the Supreme Court of the state of Washington.
I will maintain the respect due to the courts of justice.
I will maintain the respect due to the courts of justice.
And judicial officers.
And judicial officers.
I will not counsel or maintain any suit or proceeding.
I will not counsel or maintain any suit or proceeding.
Which shall appear to be unjust.
Which shall appear to me to be unjust.
Or any defense except as I believe to be honestly debatable under the law.
Or any defense except as I believe to be honestly debatable under the law.
Unless it is in the defense of a person charged with a public offense.
Unless it is in the defense of a person charged with a public offense.
I will employ for the purpose of maintaining the causes confided to me.
I will employ for the purposes of maintaining the causes confided to me.
Only those means consistent with truth and honor.
Only those means consistent with truth and honor.
I will never seek to mislead the judge or jury.
I will never seek to mislead the judge or jury.
By any artifice or false statement.
By any artifice or false statement.
I will maintain the confidence and preserve inviolate.
I will maintain the confidence and preserve inviolate.
The secrets of my client.
The secrets of my client.
And will accept no compensation.
And will accept no compensation.
In connection with the business of my client.
In connection with the business of my client.
Unless this compensation is from or with.
Unless this compensation is from or with.
The knowledge and approval of the client.
The knowledge and approval of the client.
Or with the approval of the court.
Or with the approval of the court.
I will abstain from all offensive personalities.
I will abstain from all offensive personalities.
And advance no fact prejudicial to the honor or reputation.
And advance no fact prejudicial to the honor or reputation.
Of a party or witness.
Of a party or witness.
Unless required by the justice of the cause.
Unless required by the justice of the cause.
With which I am charged.
With which I am charged.
I will never reject.
I will never reject.
From any consideration personal to myself.
From any consideration personal to myself.
The cause of the defenseless or oppressed.
The cause of the defenseless or the oppressed.
Or delay unjustly the cause of any person.
Or delay unjustly the cause of any person.
Congratulations.
Aligned with my values and regards. recovery, and I believed I could carry out the 12th step through my actions of helping others who often felt unworthy and forgotten. But as often does occur, we have one plan, and God has another, which is always for the better good. I won't lie and say that the last year was easy. For about 7 months, in between the character and fitness hearing and the Supreme Court order, it was quite messy on many days. There was plenty of tears, tons of fear and anxiety, thoughts of worry, and even new trauma that I'm still processing to this day. But there was also beauty in that time. I got to practice the spiritual principles of recovery and meditate on just for today. Just for today, if I make the right decisions, things will get better tomorrow. I would recite the Serenity Prayer, and it gave me the courage to continue. There was also a deep strengthening of my faith during that time. And now I really know that God will get me through anything. And one of the most beautiful things during that time was a coming together of a local, state, and even national community like I've never seen before. And while I appreciate all of the kind remarks about me today, and many of you may think that today is about me and my achievement, I will argue that today is really about all of you. Every single person here has played a role in my success, and there is simply no way I would have made it here without you. From the most distinguished people in this space who share their humanity and mistakes and let me know that I wasn't alone, to the folks who are coming up behind me, on the days I wanted to give up, I couldn't because of you. To my husband and family who sacrificed so much, gave space to me when I needed to study or work, but were always there when I needed you. To the lawyers who have successfully removed every roadblock to my reentry and helped me piece my life back together, including the largest legal battle. To my friends and acquaintances who send notes of support and encouragement, reminding me of my own strength and my hard-fought self-worth today. To my law school community, who valued my background since day one, trained me to be a powerful advocate for social justice, and sent me more notes of encouragement than I can count. To my clients and mentees, who helped me remember my purpose in every interaction. To the hundreds of allies who signed on the amicus brief, drafted petitions and letters, called the media, and was relentless in your advocacy for me. To my formerly incarcerated brothers and sisters, whether that's with Civil Survival, Just Leadership USA, the Formerly Incarcerated College Graduates Network, the Council, or a host of other organizations. We don't always agree on specific policies or strategies, but we share a vision and a bond that is unbreakable. And this movement keeps me going on a daily basis. To the Supreme Court, who saw me not as a record, but as a person, and made a decision that has forever changed the lives of my family and I, and has given hope to countless others. And to the currently incarcerated, we do all of this because we believe in you and care about you. You see, represented in this room today is one of the most diverse and beautiful communities that I have ever known. We come from varying education and income levels, different racial and ethnic backgrounds, ability levels, sexual orientations, and a wide range of professional and personal experience. But there is one thing we all share. We have all experienced some kind of failure or disappointment in our lives, and we all have a common love for justice, redemption, and second chances. So today, I have a new vision, and it's being created right here. My vision is that all of you, our community, will absolutely continue to fight for justice together and build a legal profession that reflects our shared values. But my vision is also that we will all learn the one skill that made all of my success possible. To reach out when we need help, because we were never meant to go through life alone. It's one thing to reach out, but in this case, all of you reached back. And that's what made today possible. Community in all of you. Today, my vision is that we will keep pulling in new members into our community until my success is no longer the exception, but rather this becomes a normal expectation. I really love all of you. Thank you for sharing this special day with me and this life in community with me.